वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द प्रैक्टिकल ऑल्सो बिकॉज इन आर सिलेबस वी आर हैविंग लाइक ओरल एंड प्रैक्टिकल एग्जाम। दैट ओरल एग्जाम ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ लाइक द होल सिलेबस एज आई डिस्कस इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस कैट कैम्प एंड द प्रैक्टिकल कैरीज अ 15 मार्क्स, 10 मार्क्स फॉर द ओरल एंड 15 मार्क्स फॉर द प्रैक्टिकल। In the case of practical, you can see over here objectives and outcomes is given over here regarding the practical and the list of exercises. This is already we discussed in the first lecture. Okay, so today I am going to start the practical number 7 first, because the practical number 7 it required like lots of amount of time to complete the practical number 7, the turning and milling. Okay, so you can see over here, this is a practical number 7 is this. Okay, part programming and part fabrication on CNC trainer, that is turning and milling both, will be learned over here how to do the coding by using the G code and M code. Okay, so this is practical number 7, and we'll see other practical also, but the practical number 7 required like lots of amount of time, so that I can start the practical number 7, and after that I will be continue with the other practical also. One thing, one more thing I have to say, all the students, you are having a small mini project in the CAD CAM. So try to form your group like 3 or maximum 4 number of the student in the single group, and try to finalize your a mini project topic and submit to me. Okay, as soon as possible, so that before end of the semester you have to submit the report as well as the physical model. Okay, so you can see at the below you are having like a two topic 8 and 9. One is geometric optimization of the any mechanical component using computer aided engineering concept. In this case you are using a shape optimization. Okay, another one, you have to develop the physical 3D mechanical structure, mechanical model using any one of the rapid prototyping process. Okay, I will see a rapid prototyping in the regular classes, that is module number 6, means in our syllabus, that is module number 6. Okay, there are number of the process are there, number of methods are there, you can select any one of the method, and according to that method you use that method and develop the any 3D model. Okay, so that is the mini project. You can take any topic, it has to be innovative. Okay, that is good. Last time, a student has a many mini project, a mini project in the form of 3D model. So try to make the different types. So you select any topic, I don't have any problem. Okay, but it has to be innovative. Okay, so you form a group and try to submit as soon as possible to me. Okay, so this is today I'm going to start the exercise number 7. I am having a 2 lecture in the week. And rather than 3 days are left, so out of 3 days we'll take 2 to 3 lecture out of 3 days regarding the practical, because I have to complete the practical as soon as possible. Okay, alright. One thing always keep in mind regarding the module number 3, that module number 3 I will be continue in the practical session. Okay, because the maximum syllabus of the module number 3 I will be complete in the practical session. This is the manual part programming, that is more or less having 70 to 80% of the module number 3. So in the practical session, in the exercise session, I will continue module number 3, and in the regular lecture we'll see if module number 2 or if module number 4 and 5, 5 and 6 I will be continue, because the module number 1 has been over and already I have given a question of the assignment. You have to complete as soon as possible till this week, okay, until Saturday. Okay, as well as already I have shared all the videos on my channels, as well as PPT numerical on your group. So try to study and try to solve as soon as possible all the questions. Okay. Today I am going to start the module number 3. As you think that module number 3 is going over here. Okay. And few part of the module number 3 I will take it as a separately at the last. Once this module has been over. Okay. Because this is like a numerical. Mostly this from this module they ask numerical for the 8 to 10 marks on the turning, on the milling. Maybe on the milling, maybe on the turning. And sometimes they ask 5 marks questions. Okay, so then that question also will see in the end of this module. So first of all, I would like to start the manual part programming. Okay, a manual part programming. Here we are going to use manually will give an input in the form of GNM code. Okay, first of all you have to know what do you mean by the NC, what do you mean by the CNC. Okay, NC, CNC and DNC. The meaning of NC, that is called the numerical control. Meaning of CNC, that is called the computer numerical control. The meaning of DNC, that is called the direct numerical control. Okay, if I say the numerical control, okay, in the case of numerical control, you are having like a manual lathe in our college also, lathe machine. Okay, in the lathe machine, you are giving the manually all the values to that lathe machine, and that lathe machine according to that work. Okay, and we are having a different types of instrument like a vernier caliper and another instrument. We always measure the diameter of the solid cylinder which required like a machining from outside or facing another operation. Okay, so we are having a different types of like instrument. By that instrument we can do the manual part, manual operations. Okay, on our lathe machine it is already there in our college also. Another, that is called a CNC. In case of CNC, there is a computer numerical control. Means the computer assist to do the part programming or to do the operation of different types of operation like the facing, milling and turning. In the case of the milling, turning and different types of operation, and if we are using like a computer to for the assistance purpose and for add of computer, here we just write down the code. Okay, and controller is there, that controller always control all the operations and read the code. According to the code it will be perform the operation. Okay, so that is called the CNC. What do you mean by DNC? The meaning of DNC, that is called the direct numerical control. Okay, the meaning of direct numerical control, the meaning of direct numerical control means I am having a one master computer and the one master computer will be connected with the number of computer. Okay, if one person is operating a master computer, that same operation will be done by all the CNC machines, all the CNC machines. So that is called a direct numerical control. So this is like a major difference. Sometime in the end semester examination they ask what is the meaning of NC, CNC and DNC. So you have to elaborate, you have to distinguish also. Okay, that is the major part. Now I am going to start the manual part programming. In the manual part programming, you can see over here. Okay, this is the manual part programming. The technique is widely used for workpiece of relatively simple geometry. And the steps are in manual part programming. What is the first step? Okay, you have to remember this step as well as you have to note down anywhere, wherever you require it. Okay, careful study of a component drawing. Some component is given for the different types of operation. First of all, you have to do the careful study of that component. Okay, and what are the material, tolerance and surface finish is given in the drawing. Next, select the raw material or blank if not specified. Sometime a drawing is given. Okay, in the drawing they are giving the material also, like a different types of steel material are there. Okay, and aluminium are there and different materials. It is specified on the drawing sheet itself, but sometime it is not given on the drawing sheet. It means that you have to select a raw material, okay, if it is not specified. Next point, the point number 3. पॉइंट नंबर टू इज ओवर. सेलेक्ट द नंबर ऑफ सेटअप नेसेसरी एंड मशीन ऑन विच द पार्ट इज मशीन मीन्स नंबर ऑफ सेटअप दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड दैट इज नीडेड एज वेल एज अ मशीन. देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मशीन एज यू ऑलरेडी हर्ड अबाउट दैट मशीन. ओके मशीन लाइक वर्टिकल मिलिंग मशीन हॉरिजॉन्टल मिलिंग मशीन. ओके सम टाइम फॉर द स्लॉटिंग पर्पज वी आर यूजिंग द इन्वर्सल मशीन ऑल्सो. तो यू हैव टू सेलेक्ट द मशीन ऑल्सो. ओके डिसाइडिंग द वर्क पीस डेटम फॉर ई सेटअप दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके यू हैव टू डिसाइड द रेफरेंस पॉइंट दैट इज कॉल्ड द डेटम. ओके इफ यू नॉट डिसाइड द प्रॉपर डेटम इट मे डैमेज द टूल ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. नेक्स्ट डिजाइन द फीचर्स और होल्डिंग ऑफ द जॉब. यू ऑलरेडी स्टडी इन द लोअर क्लासेस लाइक पीटीडी टू डिजाइन इन द सेमेस्टर 5 दैट वट डू मीन बाय द फीचर्स एंड what do you mean by the fixture and this and fixture. Okay so you have to design the fixture as you required because different types of material require different types of holding because if it is not proper design the fixtures the material will be vibrate and because of that maybe the material will be spoiled. Okay so you have to design the proper fixtures. Next point number 6 decide in the process and sequence of process to achieve the desired accuracy and tolerance. Okay, now in this case, you have to decide the different types of process. First, which process you have to do. Okay, rough milling, surface milling, and different types of process. First, you have to do the boring, and after that, you have to do the drilling. Okay, because whenever we need to do a drilling, we have to do first punching. Okay, हम पहले punch करते हैं. Once we done the punching, we start drilling at that point. Okay, or if I want to do internal taping, so first of all you have to do the punching and different operations. Okay, this is also very important parameter, very important point. You have to select the tool as well as the cutting parameter and the tool material also. There are different types of tool, are there carbide tool, are there okay steel carbide tool, and different types of tools are there. You have to select the tool with respect to material you're going to cut. Okay, if you select like a ductile material tool to cut the hard material, the ductile material tool will damage. Okay, so you have to select the proper tool and their material as well as the cutting parameter. There are different types of cutting parameters are there. Okay, that parameter, for example, we are having a feed rate, depth of cut. Okay, and speed also, feed rate, depth of cut, speed, time, heat, and there are different types of cutting parameters are there. You have to select all the cutting parameter. Okay, other than it will be difficult to do the different types of operations. Writing the program, after that all the point you have read it out and you have done the proper observation each and every point. After that, you start writing the program. Okay, writing the program as we required to do operations. Next, input the program and dry run. What do you mean by the dry run? The meaning of the dry run, that is called the trial. Okay, dry run, that means you have to go first a trial. Okay, you have to do the trial. Okay, it is properly like a tool is moving or not moving. Okay, or it will be like not damaging the tool, proper datum we have selected and different types of things. Okay, that is called the dry run. Means dry run, that is called the first trial. Okay, we have to do the trial. Okay, correct the mistakes if any there. Produce the first part and inspect. Okay, first of all you have to produce a single part and you have to inspect. It is up to the mark or it is not up to the mark. If any mistakes are there, you have to do the improvement. Okay, if not any mistakes are there in the part, you have to continue. Okay, sometime program is not correct and lots of problem are there, so you have to correct the program if necessary and progress to the lot production. Okay, point number 12, create the documentation for the future reference. Okay, in the computer aided engineering, it is very important, and we have to create the document for the future reference, keep in the safe place so that we can use in the future, or whenever we required we can change it. Okay, so this is like a 12 point, point number 12. Okay, now I'm proceeding with the next slide, that is the manual part programming. Okay, in the case of manual part programming, we are using the some syntax. The actual syntax of the program varies from the machine to machine. However, regardless of a kind of controller used, there are different types of controller, okay, using a different types of companies, okay, that is always depend on it. A typical NC-CNC program consists of a 6 blocks, okay. So, this 6 blocks also you have to remember, okay. The first, okay, program startup. The section serves to issue any command required at the start of the tap only. For example, setting the program to the millimeter mode would be the needed only at the beginning of the program. Okay, this is very important. If you remember that in case of solid modeling and solid works, okay, before starting the solid modeling or solid works or for designing any kind of model, you have to select the unit. Okay, sometimes by default unit you have select inches and you start drawing, but in the drawing sheet given in the mm, so it is like again you have to go and your time has waste. Okay, so you have to keep in mind, try to select the unit first. Okay, and that unit is very important. Okay, in this case, tool safety block. To solve the issues, command to cancel any machine modes that could have remained active in case of an interrupted tool and cycle by issuing the certain initialization command, and the programmer can ensure the safety of machine tool. Okay, tool safety block, you can see after whenever I start a drawing. Okay, so this is also very important. Tool load blocks. Okay, there are different types of code we are using for the tool loading, like M06, that is a M code. Okay, so there are different types of code we are using for the tool loading. Okay, that we will see during the regular session of the practical. And tool for the tool compensation, also tool length, also we are having different types of code, like the G41, G42, G43, G44. There are different types of codes are there, we'll see. Tool motion blocks. For the tool motion blocks, we are having some motion codes. That code we will use at the starting. Okay. Tool cancel blocks. There are different types of tool cancel blocks are there that we will use for cancellation of tool. For example, sometimes we are using a can cycle. For cancellation of the can cycle, or we are using a sometimes G80, G81. Some codes we are using for the cancellation of the block. That also we will see during the practical session. End of the block. Just a minute. Make a little side so that. Different types of codes are there, that codes we are using for the end of the block, that also we can see whenever we are going to write the program. Okay, so this is like a 6 steps are there, you have to know and you have to remember these 6 steps. Okay, first step is program startup state, second tool safety block, third tool load block, fourth, here we can see the fourth. Tool motion blocks, tool cancel blocks, and end of the tab blocks. Okay, next we are having, that is called the word address format. There are different types of formats are there. Okay, there are 3 types of formats are there. First format is called the sequential format. The meaning of the sequential format I'll tell you. Okay, the word n, this is called the सीक्वेंस इन द सिक्वेंशियल फॉर्मेट इफ आई एम स्टार्ट राइटिंग द सिक्वेंस सिक्वेंस नंबर वन और सिक्वेंस नंबर टू सिक्वेंस नंबर थ्री ओके सिक्वेंस नंबर फोर एंड आई एम राइटिंग द राइटिंग टू स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम ऑल्सो लाइक दिस वे ओके इफ आई वॉन्ट टू चेंज समथिंग ओवर हियर और इन बिटवीन इट इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट इन केस ऑफ सिक्वेंसिंग फॉर्मेट ओके यू हैव टू डिलीट ऑल दोज थिंग्स देन यू हैव टू रीच ओवर देयर So this is like a disadvantage of the sequential format. Another, we are having a tab format. The meaning of the tab format, for example, I am writing a some sequence number here and I have to give a some tab. Tab means a some space as a tab and then writing a next code. Okay. The disadvantages of this format that it required like a huge amount of a memory to save that program okay so that also we are not using we are always using the word address format okay word address format because this word address format is overcome both disadvantages and comes under the advantage it is the one of the most common machine use word address format was developed as a tab programming format And it is sometimes also referred as a variable block format. Okay, this is also referred as a variable block format. As the program line in the code maybe have a block of varying length, though word address format was the aim for the TAP format. It is still use a manual data input for CNC machine. Word address format uses the alphanumeric characters in a programming. We'll see in the next or next to next lecture and practical how we can write down the G code and M code in the case of word address format. The first character is in the alphabet and is also the address character. The operation is described in the form of block. The block format for word address RS follows. You can see over here. Okay, and one by one each alphabet. We will study in the next slide. Okay. What do you mean by here? You heard about like a tape. Okay. The meaning of tape programming format. Okay. In like one decade or two decade back or in that era, we can say they are using like a tape for giving a. What we can say instruction to the machine means we are having like a tape like this way okay aisa tape hota tha okay aisa tape ye tape aisa hota tha I'll tell you I'm the rough diagram I'm drawing over here okay and on this tape small and some hole and some structure was there okay small and bigger hole are there okay and that each and every hole and each and every geometry on this tape having a some meaning okay some meaning and this tape is passes through some light rays and that will be cover that which operation have to do by the machine okay so this is the called the tape okay okay now the first letter is called the n okay and that n called the sequence number okay this is the block sequence number as I said okay this is the always block sequence number ye sequence number hota hai theek hai and is used to number the line of the NC code and n number are ignored by the controller during the program execution however the blocks can be searched by the controller through the sequence number typically n is followed by the minimum of 3 digit to identify the line for example we are having the example over here you can see n005 n10 n1015 agar tumne pehla number 5 diya to dusra wala ke aur tisre wale ke beech mein 5 ka difference aa jayega tum yahan par kuch bhi de sakte ho jahan n0 n01 bhi de sakte ho तो N01 दिए तो दूसरा वाला N03 हो जाएगा, फिर N05 हो जाएगा, N02 दिया तो हर एक के बीच में एक गैप आ जाएगा, ठीक है। तो सिक्वेंस नंबर इज गिवन एट द ब्लॉक हेड एंड नीड टू बी कंस्ट्रक्टिव इफ नंबर सिक्वेंस एंड नंबर और द सेम नंबर आर गिवन टू द मल्टीपल ब्लॉक देन दे कैनॉट बी यूज फॉर द प्रोग्राम जम्प। तो दिस इज कॉल्ड द एंड। नेक्स्ट जी कोड, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। ओके जी कोड, दिस इज कॉल्ड द प्रिपरेटरी फंक्शंस और दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। मेनी टाइम एक्सटर्नल एग्जामिनर आस्क व्हाट डू मीन बाय द प्रिपरेटरी फंक्शंस, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द जी कोड। दिस इनिशिएट्स अ प्रिपरेटरी फंक्शन, दिस फंक्शन चेंजेस द कंट्रोल मोड ऑफ द मशीन एंड आर कॉमनली रेफर्ड टू एज अ जी कोड। द जी कोड इज टिपिकली फॉलोड बाय टू डिजिट। ओके टू डिजिट, यू कैन सी ओवर देयर देयर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ जी कोड, टू डिजिट एज पर ई आई ए और ऑल्सो ISO स्टैंडर्ड, द टू डिजिट फॉलोड बाई जी इंडिकेट द प्री डिफाइंड फंक्शन। सम ऑफ द कॉमन फंक्शन आर गिवन ओवर हियर। ओके तो ये जो जी कोड से तुमको ना बाय हार्ट होना चाहिए, आई बात समझ में, क्या होना चाहिए तुमको बाय हार्ट। अगर तुमको ये बाय हार्ट नहीं है तो ये तुम प्रोग्राम नहीं ले सकते, ठीक है। बाय हार्ट होने के साथ साथ यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द फंक्शन ऑफ द ईच एंड एवरी कोड। फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई से G00, द मीनिंग ऑफ G00 रैपिड ट्रैवल एक्सेस मोशन एट द मैक्सिमम स्पीड। रैपिड ट्रैवल मीन्स अगर समझ जाओ आई एम हैविंग अ ये यहाँ पर एक बट वर्क पीस है। अब ये टूल एक्चुअली में यहाँ रहता है, टूल यहाँ पर है। अब ये टूल को यहाँ पर लाना है मुझे, कहाँ पर, यहाँ पर लाना है। तो उसके लिए मैं सबसे पहले क्या यूज करूँ, G00 मीन्स आई हैव टू लोकेट द लोकेशन बाई यूजिंग द G00, दैट इज कॉल्ड द रैपिड ट्रैवल। तुमने ऑलरेडी ये पढ़ा है सारा लाइक इन PP2 में, PP2 में ऑलरेडी तुमने ये सब पढ़ा है, मीन्स ऑलरेडी इन द लोअर क्लासेज यू स्टडीड दिस पार्ट। ओके नाउ द फर्स्ट कोड एज आई सेड इज द रैपिड ट्रैवल। फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम हैविंग द कंपोनेंट ओवर हियर एंड आई वॉन्ट टू लोकेट दैट टूल एट द हियर so that I can start the operation from here, I am using the G00. That is used as a same as milling and same as in lathe also. G01 linear interpolation straight line axis motion at the control feed rate. Okay, it is only used for the straight line. Okay, straight line operations ke liye we are using a G01. G02 clockwise circular motion using two axis in a single program block. Okay. इट इज अ क्लॉक वाइज सर्कुलर मोशन। अगर क्लॉक वाइज ऐसा कोई क्लॉक वाइज सर्कुलर मोशन करना है, आई वॉन्ट टू कट लाइक दिस वे, ओके दिस वे आई एम टेकिंग लिटिल आउटसाइड, ओके फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट आई हैव टू यूज G02। फॉर द एंटी क्लॉक वाइज पर्पज आई एम यूजिंग G03। ओके एंड फॉर द ड्यूल, द मीनिंग ऑफ ड्यूल आई वॉन्ट टू गिव सम डिले बिटवीन द टू ऑपरेशन, तो आई एम यूजिंग G04। This is very important code because many times the external examiner asks how we can give the delay and dual in case of programming. So you have to use a G04. Okay, you have to use the G04. So this is like a four codes are there, you have to remember. Okay. So today I am going to like stop my lecture over here. In the next lecture we'll see the next code, but you have to write down this code. Okay, you have to write down. Okay, thank you very much.
सर ये तो प्रैक्टिस के बाद ही